I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making cauliflower breadsticks. And I'm calling it breadsticks because it does not contain flour. Instead, we're using cauliflower, eggs, and cheese to make up the breadsticks. And this is a way that you can feel like you're having breadsticks, but you're having it in a healthy way. It won't have nearly as many calories as the bread type. So what we need to do is get a large head of cauliflower, and we need to wash this and then to cut it into chunks and get it prepared for the microwave. After you've cut up your cauliflower into chunks like this, then you're going to put it in a large bowl. I have a very large bowl here, and you need to cover it with plastic wrap and then use the microwave. If you don't have a microwave or you don't like this method, then you can boil this in water. Just put water up to cover it, bring it to a boil, and then cook until tender. And I'll use my fork to test for tenderness, so it'll probably take 5 minutes or so in the microwave. I'll keep track of the time, and I will be stopping every once in a while and testing with the fork to see if it's tender enough to mash, because we are going to mash these. I've just gotten my cauliflower out of the microwave. I cooked it on high, and I cooked it for 8 minutes. I was checking every 2 minutes at the beginning, and then a little oftener than that at the end. And you can see it's very hot, and when you test it with a fork, the fork goes in very easily, and that means you can use a mixer, or you can use a blender, or a food processor to mix this up. So the next step is to get this into our food processor. When you're getting your cauliflower into your food processor, make sure that it's free of water. If you need to blot it with paper toweling, then do that. If there's water standing in that bowl, then you definitely want to drain it out and try to get it as free of water as possible. Next, we're adding 2 well-beaten eggs. Just put that around. And then we're adding cheese, which is 4 ounces. And then we have 2 cloves of garlic, minced. We have 1/2 teaspoon of onion powder. That's onion powder, not onion salt. And then we'll take care of our salt by just going around and doing this to taste. If you like things a little saltier, then put plenty in. I always try to go a little shy on it, and then I can add it later if necessary. Also, ground a little pepper if you like pepper in your foods. Freshly ground peppercorns are good. There we go. And that's all we're going to put in right now. So what I need to do is get this lined up and closed. And then I've got this plugged in here in the back and turning the power on. And I think we'll just do pulse and watch it for a little bit. And it's very fast to process, but I think what I want to do is to scrape the sides down and then just turn it to full processing mode and then stop when I think it's ready. I've scraped down the sides, and you probably will need to stop and do that at some point. And now let's just let it go. I gave this about 30 additional seconds of processing, and you can see that it looks like mashed potatoes. And if you like to eat it like that, you can, because everything is fine. The eggs actually were put in raw, but with the heat involved here, I think that would probably cook them well enough. But our dish is breadsticks, so we're going to use a bread pan. This is just a baking pan that I have sprayed cooking oil spray on, and what I need to do is to bring this out and spread what I have in a layer that is about 1/2 inch thick. This is what your mixture looks like after it's patted out into your baking pan, and it's pretty easy to get it nice and level. Now, this recipe is really popular on the internet right now. So if you just do a search for cauliflower breadsticks, you'll find lots of recipes for it. I took two or three recipes and combined what I thought were the best parts of them, and then to give it a little twist of my own, I'm going to make it more Italian style. On the top, I'm going to put some grated Parmesan cheese, just this kind that you get in a can. And then over the top of that, I'm going to grind something that I have here, which is called Italian seasoning. You might not have that or be able to find it, but you could use some Italian seasonings that are dried, which would be a mixture of maybe oregano and basil and parsley. But just a light dusting over the top, and then take this to a 450 degree preheated oven and let it bake, watching it carefully, and it should start to brown up in about 20 minutes or so. And you will remove it from the oven, let it cool slightly, and then you can cut it into sticks. Now, don't expect these sticks to be crusty and crispy like breadsticks that are made from flour. These are going to be softer. So it could be that you won't be able to hold them in your hand, but you may want to put some on a dish and eat it like that. It just depends on how much water the cauliflower retained in your particular recipe. So into the oven at 450, and we'll be back soon. Here are our cauliflower breadsticks straight from the oven, so this is very hot. I'm going to let it rest just a few minutes, and then I'll take a knife and cut it in pieces. Now our breadsticks are really hot still, but I wanted to show you what would happen if you started cutting them sort of crosswise, I guess, and then cutting lengthwise. Then you will get a little stick like this, and you can manage it. They're just very fragile, so you have to be very careful with them, and that's kind of stuck on the edge, so it's tearing apart. But when you get them ready, you can bring them over and put them on a serving plate. So I think I'll let these cool down a little bit in order to get a nice plateful. But for tasting, I think I'll just bring these over and put them on my plate. And then right here I have the marinara sauce, or the pizza sauce that we made in a previous video, and I've heated it up, so it's warm right now. And I will tell you, and I probably will have this in the write-up if you have looked at it, I added 1 tablespoon of sugar and it tasted a lot better to me. So if you don't mind adding that extra sugar, you probably will like the flavor a little better. So I'm just going to have this as my little dipping bowl. And then it's kind of hard to actually bring one of these up and hold it like a breadstick, but you can manage to do that if you want to. I think what I'll do is just take some of the sauce and spread it along the top. And then I would rather eat it with a fork when it's this hot. Now when it cools down, you'll probably have really good luck with it. That is good. This is considered to be diet food because, you know, the marinara sauce was all vegetables except a little bit of olive oil, and then I put that sugar in, which was for the whole bunch. And then this, our breadsticks, is this combination of cauliflower, eggs, and cheese, and then some spices and some salt and pepper. So really, it's a good substitute for actual bread made out of flour. It has some Parmesan cheese on the top, and as you eat it, you might want to sprinkle a little extra on there. Now, what I got tasted mainly like the pizza sauce, so I'm going over to this one where I can tell you what the cauliflower breadstick tastes like. It is so good. Honestly, you would not think it was not bread if you weren't told that it was made out of cauliflower. So if you want to trick somebody and get them to eat something healthy, you can make this, and it really tastes like bread. And it's a very flavorful bread because of the spices in there, and also the cheese helps a lot. And the egg binding it together, it just all works. So I hope you can use this recipe, particularly as you're starting the new year. If you have a resolution to eat less calories, you could eat this whole thing probably and not have as many calories as you would have in an order of French fries. So I hope that this is helpful to you, and I think I am going to enjoy it, and I think Rick will too, because we're eating light nowadays.